As of today, we're living in an era where our understanding of the universe is expanding faster than the universe itself. But today, we're not just going to talk about the usual "when are we setting foot on Mars" kind of questions. Instead, we're going to ponder something a little more cosmic. What if we took every single star in the universe and squeezed them all into our very own Milky Way? Now, the Milky Way is a spiral galaxy that contains hundreds of billions of stars. The universe, on the other hand, is vast and contains trillions of galaxies. So it seems like a ridiculous question, but what if it's not? Imagine if we could actually somehow squeeze all the stars in the universe into the Milky Way. What would it look like? Would it be a blindingly bright ball of light, or would it just be a slightly denser version of our galaxy? Well, picture standing at the edge of an ocean so vast, it stretches beyond the horizon and disappears into infinity. Each drop of water in this ocean represents a star. This ocean is so immense that it would take you over 93 billion years to cross it from one end to the other, even if you were traveling at the speed of light. That's the scale of the observable universe we're talking about. But keep in mind, the observable universe is only the part that we can see, and even then it's a distance so vast, it's almost impossible to comprehend. And within this vast expanse, there are an estimated 2 trillion galaxies, each filled with billions or even trillions of stars. It's like a cosmic forest, with each galaxy a unique tree, and each star a unique leaf. However, these galaxies in the universe are not randomly distributed. They form a cosmic web, with clusters of galaxies linked by filaments of dark matter, creating a structure that's as beautiful as it is complex. Now, let's bring our focus closer to home. If the universe is an endless ocean, then our Milky Way galaxy is a single drop in that ocean. It's not the biggest or the smallest galaxy in the universe, but to us, it's the most important one because it's ours. Imagine our Milky Way as a bustling cosmic metropolis in the vast expanse of the universe. It's a barred spiral galaxy, which means it has a central bar-shaped structure composed of stars, with arms that spiral outwards. If you could view it from the outside, it would look like a cosmic whirlpool, spinning in the vast ocean of the universe. Kind of like a celestial whirlpool, but without the water. Now let's talk about the size of our city. Our galaxy spans about 100,000 light-years in diameter, meaning that if you were traveling at the speed of light, it would take you 100,000 years to cross it from one side to the other. To put that into perspective, if the Milky Way were the size of the United States, our solar system would be smaller than a quarter, and you thought your commute was long. Our cosmic city is teeming with life, made up of an estimated 100 to 400 billion stars, along with a whole lot of gas and dust. Each star represents a building, and the gas and dust are like the roads and parks that fill the spaces in between. It's a city that never sleeps because, well, it's always nighttime. But where do we fit in this city? We're located in a nice, quiet suburb about 26,000 light years from the galactic center. The center of the galaxy, for example, is a bit of a rough spot with a supermassive black hole named Sagittarius A at its heart. It's the cosmic equivalent of that one sketchy neighborhood every city seems to have. In the grand scheme of the universe, our city, the Milky Way, is part of a local group of about 54 galaxies, which in turn is part of the Virgo supercluster. So we're not just a building in a city, but a city in a country, in a continent, on the planet that is the universe. Now, for the ultimate cosmic challenge, what would happen if we tried to squeeze all the stars in the universe into our cosmic city? Well, it would be like trying to fit all the people in the world into a grain of sand. The density of the universe would be so high that it would defy our current understanding of the laws of physics. That's pretty crazy, right? But when we gaze at the night sky, it might seem like the stars are close together. In reality, they're incredibly far apart. The nearest star to us, Proxima Centauri, is about 4.24 light years away. That's roughly 40 trillion kilometers or 25 trillion miles. If we were to scale down the universe so that the Earth is the size of a pea, Proxima Centauri would be over 300 kilometers or about 186 miles away. That's like the distance from New York City to Washington, D.C. Now, let's think about the sheer number of stars in the universe. We've already established that there are about 100 to 400 billion stars in the Milky Way. But remember, there are an estimated 2 trillion galaxies in the observable universe. Even if each of those galaxies had only 1 billion stars, far less than our own Milky Way, that would still be 2 sextillion stars. That's a 2 with 21 zeros behind it. If each star were a single sheet of paper, the stack would reach to the moon and back over 300 times. But what if we ignored the laws of physics for a moment and thought about fitting all those stars side by side into the Milky Way? For simplicity's sake, let's imagine each star as a tennis ball. In reality, the average distance between stars in the Milky Way is about 5 light-years, a distance so vast that if we were to line up these tennis balls, the chain would be long enough to wrap around the Earth's equator over 200 million times. But could we fit all these tennis balls into the Milky Way? Now, stars vary greatly in size, from the size of our Sun, which is about 1.4 million kilometers in diameter, to stars that are 1,800 times larger. But for this exercise, let's consider each star to be about the average size of our Sun. Well, it turns out that we could. The volume of the Milky Way is so vast that even with 2 sextillion stars, we'd still have room to spare. It's like trying to fill a swimming pool with grains of sand. Even trillions of grains would barely make a dent. Now, in terms of the average distance between each star, if we packed them as closely as possible, it would be on the order of a few light days or less, compared to the current average distance between stars in the Milky Way of several light years. This is like if major cities like New York, London, and Tokyo are all within a stone's throw of each other. However, when we bring physics back into the mix, let's just say things get a bit more interesting. So, let's start with gravity, the cosmic glue that holds everything together. Each star has its own gravitational pull, like each person has their own personal bubble. Now, imagine squeezing all these stars into the Milky Way. The gravitational forces would skyrocket, leading to a cosmic bumper car scenario with stars colliding and merging, creating supernova and black holes. Think about it like that one elevator where everyone is squished inside. Density, or how much mass is packed into a given volume, would also go through the roof. Picture the Sun as a single grain of rice. Now, consider that stars in the universe would range from tiny specks of dust to objects thousands of times larger than the grain of rice itself. If we were to pack all those stars, from dust specks to larger grains, into a space the size of a small suitcase, representing the Milky Way, we'd end up with a density so high it would make a black hole blush. Then, there's the Milky Way structure to consider. Our galaxy isn't just a random jumble of stars. It's a carefully arranged disk with stars, gas, and dust spiraling out from the center. Adding more stars would make the galaxy collapse. It's like adding more floors to a skyscraper without reinforcing the foundation. Eventually, it's going to topple over. Speaking of structure, let's not forget about the space that all these stars would be squeezed into. It's not just an empty void. It's filled with interstellar medium, a mix of gas and dust. Squeezing more stars into the Milky Way would be like trying to fit more water into an already full glass. Eventually, it's going to overflow, and the structure and stability of the Milky Way would be drastically affected. Our galaxy, as we know it, would cease to exist. The immense gravitational forces would cause the galaxy to collapse into a supermassive black hole. This would not only be the end of the Milky Way, but could also disrupt the structure of the entire universe. Moreover, the gravitational waves produced by such a massive event would ripple across the universe, potentially disrupting other galaxies and celestial bodies in their path. Interestingly, this thought experiment brings us to the edge of our understanding of physics. It forces us to confront the limitations of our theories and pushes us to explore new frontiers in our quest to understand the universe. For instance, it raises questions about the nature of dark matter and dark energy, the most mysterious concepts in modern cosmology that make up about 95% of the universe. Could their properties change under such extreme conditions? We don't know. And that's what makes this so fascinating. But what we do know is that dark matter is a type of matter that we can't see directly. It doesn't emit, absorb, or reflect light, which makes it incredibly difficult to detect. However, we know it's there because of the gravitational effects it has on visible matter. For example, galaxies rotate at speeds that should tear them apart, given the amount of visible matter they contain. The fact that they stay intact suggests that there's a lot more matter there that we can't see. Dark energy, on the other hand, is even more mysterious. It's a form of energy that permeates all of space and is believed to be the reason why the universe is expanding at an accelerating rate. It's like an invisible force field that fills empty space, and its effects become more noticeable as the universe continues to grow. Dark matter and dark energy have a significant influence on the universe and the distribution of stars. Dark matter's gravity pulls matter together, helping to form galaxies and clusters of galaxies. Dark energy, in contrast, works against gravity, pushing everything apart. So when we talk about fitting all the stars in the universe into the Milky Way, we have to consider not just the stars themselves, but also the unseen forces of dark matter and dark energy. These invisible components of the universe play a crucial role in shaping the cosmos and our understanding of it. It's a humbling thought, isn't it? Even as we strive to understand the universe, there's so much more out there beyond our current comprehension. But that's what makes the journey of discovery so exciting. Despite the crazy scale and complexity of the universe, we humans have always been driven to explore and understand it. But how does this quest for knowledge tie into our star-studded question? Well, the future of astronomy, brimming with exciting possibilities, might just bring us closer to such cosmic mysteries. Consider the advancements in technology. We're not just talking about your latest smartphone update, but newer and more powerful telescopes. Take the James Webb Space Telescope, for instance. This isn't just another piece of space hardware. It's a time machine that will allow us to look further into the universe than ever before, revealing galaxies from the early universe that we've never seen. While telescopes give us a distant view of the universe, space missions allow us to explore it firsthand. Take NASA's Artemis program, for example. This isn't just a family trip to the moon, but an ambitious project that aims to establish a sustainable human presence there. Imagine living in a lunar base, watching Earth rise over the horizon. Now that's a room with a view. Moreover, advancements in computing power like artificial intelligence are enabling us to create more accurate simulations of the universe. These aren't your average video games, but powerful tools that can help us understand the behavior of galaxies, the distribution of dark matter, and the effects of black holes. These breakthroughs have the potential to revolutionize our understanding of the universe. They might even help us unravel one of the biggest mysteries out there, dark matter. Right now, our grasp of physics can't quite explain what it is, but who knows what we might uncover in the future. We might even stumble upon a cosmic shrink ray. Just don't tell Ant-Man we found it first. But as we stand on the precipice of these exciting new frontiers in astronomy, we can eagerly anticipate a future brimming with discovery. The universe, with its vastness and mysterious nature, is gradually revealing its secrets to us, piece by piece and star by star. So let us continue to gaze upwards, for the next groundbreaking revelation may be just a telescope away. And always remember, although the universe may seem impossibly immense, our pursuit of knowledge and understanding is a journey that unfolds one star at a time. With that in mind, I encourage you to keep exploring and share in the comments your favorite astronomical mystery that fascinates you the most. Thank you so much for accompanying me on this journey. If you found this video enjoyable, please hit that like button and subscribe for more captivating explorations of our universe. And remember, the universe is vast, mysterious, and teeming with stars, even though not all of them can find a home within our Milky Way. And until we meet again, keep reaching for the stars.